गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड फाइन एट होम एंड स्टडिंग वेल. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड प्रोनाउंस. सो वी विल हैव अ क्विक रिकैप ऑफ प्रोनाउन. प्रोनाउंस आर द वर्ड्स विच आर यूज्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ नाउन, और वी कैन से दैट प्रोनाउंस are the words which are used to avoid the repetition of noun. So continuing the types of pronoun in this video, first of all we will start with indefinite pronoun. So children, what is indefinite pronoun? Sometimes the pronouns used in a sentence do not refer to any particular thing or person. They are used in a general way. Such pronouns are known as indefinite pronouns. So children, indefinite refers to anyone. We are not talking about any particular or person or thing. So to refer anyone, generally we use indefinite pronouns. So children, for example, you can see a lot of words are here. These all are indefinite pronouns, like all, anyone, anybody, anything, everyone, everybody, etc. So just have a look at the examples now. The very first example is, nobody can help you in this issue. It means we are talking of generally that no one is there to help you. See the second one. Did you ask anybody to come? So children, if we talk about anybody, so anybody can come. We are not referring to a particular person. We are talking about anyone. Somebody has stolen my watch. So in this sentence, somebody is our indefinite pronoun. We are not sure that who has stolen the watch. The next pronoun we have is relative pronoun. So from the word itself, we can say that relative pronoun are used to relate something. So a relative pronoun is one which is used to refer to nouns mentioned previously, whether they are people, places, things, animals or ideas. Relative pronouns can be used to join two sentences. So basically, relative pronouns are those pronouns which relate the noun present in a sentence to the rest part of the sentence. They relate the noun to the rest part of the sentence in one or other context. For example, who, whom, that, which, whoever, whomever, and whichever. These are the words which do the function of relative pronouns. So just have a look at the sentences. This is the place where we met. So children, in this sentence, where is the relative pronoun? So it is connecting two parts of the sentence. This is the place where we met. So where is establishing a relation between the meeting and the place. In the second sentence, we can see that you can choose one person, whomever you like. So whomever is the relative pronoun means you can choose anyone, whomsoever you like. The last example is, he who hesitates is lost. So if I ask you a question, who hesitates? So we can say that he who hesitates is lost. Coming to the next one is demonstrative pronoun. So children, demonstrative pronouns indicates the object that we try to describe or tell you the specific distance of the object. So children, basically demonstrative pronouns are the pronouns which are merely used to indicate the noun about which we are talking. They just point out the things. So we have two demonstrative pronouns. The first one is this and the second one is that. So this is basically used to point out the things or persons which are near to someone. And that is used to point out the things which are far. So this is the singular form and plural of this is these. Similarly, that is the singular demonstrative pronoun and those is the plural demonstrative pronoun. Let's have a look at the sentences. If we talk about first sentence, this is my book. So children, what is the function of demonstrative pronoun? It just refers to the things that this is my book. So, one more thing you have to notice in this sentence, book is a singular subject. So, we have used this. If we see the second example, these are my books. So, children, you have to pay attention when the noun is plural, we have to use these or those. And when the noun is singular, we will be using this or that. Now we come to the third sentence, that man is handsome. So if any person, anything which you want to refer, they are far from you, so you have to use the demonstrative pronoun that. Coming to the next one, interrogative pronoun. So interrogative, I think from the word interrogative itself it is clear. The pronouns that are used for asking questions, they are known as interrogative pronouns. Or we can say question asking pronouns are called interrogative pronouns. So following are the words that come under the category of interrogative pronouns. The first one is what, who, which, whose, whom, etc. Now coming to the examples, who is there, what do you want, which are your books and whom did you see? So children, let's have a look between difference between relative pronoun and interrogative pronoun. We have read that relative pronoun relates the noun with the rest part of the sentence. So see here, it is used to connect clause or phrase to a noun or pronoun. So clause also is a part of sentence. So see the example. A man who lost his wallet could not buy his groceries. So the relative pronoun can establish the connection between the starting or subject can be in the form of noun also, or it can be in the form of pronoun also. And what is the work of interrogative pronouns? It is used in order to ask a question. So the example is, who is Mohan? So children, what is common between two examples? Who is common? But same time, you people notice that who can be used as a relative pronoun also, and who is also an interrogative pronoun. But their work is totally different. So children, here we finish our pronouns. We will soon meet in the next video with our next grammar topic. Till then, keep studying, stay safe, stay home. Bye children.